I've got a question from Shane Hawkins, who asks, how do the elves store the information that they come across?
Good question, Shane. So one way they store information is on the web forum. Okay, so if you go to qr.com/talk, you'll see all these threads going back for 17 years, starting with A. There'll be apples and Arizona and astronomy and Arkansas and that kind of stuff. And there'll be one already started on Q. So usually started by members of the public think, oh, Queens, that's a good thread to start. And so anyone can contribute to this. So there's sort of an open area. And then inside that, there is actually a secret area, a sort of elf parlour, where they all sit.
Secret
on,
garden.
Yes, and they swap information. And it actually is the way QI started. It was originally designed, QI, not to be a telly show at all, but to be a huge online encyclopedia, which we're still keen to do. So one day you'll be able to access everything that the elves have found out in the last 20 years.
And how can you tell that the fact that you've come across is worthy of going into the show? Is it by other people's reactions, or do you just have a gut instinct that that one, that's definitely going to make the cut?
The answer is that what QI does is different to the way most television runs, which is you're asked only to write down what you personally find interesting. So the elves are all self-propelling. Nobody actually works for me, they work for themselves. And that is the hardest thing, in fact, when finding a QI researcher, to find someone who has the self-confidence to know, I find this interesting.
Can I just say, I definitely want a self-propelling elf. That's for Christmas, if you could
get me. Oh, there's one there.
Get me one of those, that would be fantastic. So people contribute to QI from all over the world. Is it true there was an outpost in China?
There was. They were trying to translate everything we knew at that time in sort of 2003-04 into Chinese to start a Chinese office. And unfortunately, so they said, the database blew off a balcony in the wind. And I said, now what, the whole laptop?
Yeah,
was it written down? Anyway, that's what they said. And they came back with nothing. It was rather an expensive 2 years holiday in Chengdu.
But I think in terms of excuses for not doing your homework, my laptop blew away.
Yeah.
It's one of the best I've ever
heard.
In China.
I was in China, my laptop blew off the balcony.
Yeah.
What can you do?
Could have happened to anybody.
Yeah, absolutely.
So that was a question from Shane Hawkins. Yeah. Now, Hawkins obviously comes from Hodge, which was originally Roger.
Oh.
So Hawkins, small Roger.
Of course, the Irish for John.
Yeah.
Like moi. I mean, yeah. It's God's gift, Shane, as you probably know.
Shane, just your real name is actually John, very small Rogering. Just saying.